Hi, and welcome to Gardening on the West Fork. Today, I'm going to show you how simple it is to install your own water barrel. That is a must for any backyard gardener. I've had one for 5 years now, and I can't live without it. It just makes watering all your planted pots so much easier. Where I'm standing here is where I do a lot of my potting anyway. It's on a little lower patio right outside of my storage area. And it's so nice to have that water accessible. But what I'm going to show you is in the winter months when the barrel isn't hooked up, this is just coming from a downspout, and that's what your water barrels are all about. If you have a downspout in your side yard, you just have to adapt it to your rain barrel. This is coming off the porch, and all we've done is attached a curved piece right here from the roof downspout. And in the winter, we attach this long black tube, plastic tube that directs the water away from the house when we're not using it for the barrel, over the top garden and into the yard. And I've already taken the screws out of here, so it makes it simpler for you to see how we then put my rain barrel to use. And here it is. This is a 50-gallon rain barrel, lightweight, picked it up from Home Depot for under 60 bucks. And you can see that on the top part, there are the holes inside. The whole area is holes so that the water can spill in and fill up your barrel. The other things that they have, which is really nice, they all are come with a spigot. And I seldom use a spigot because I use all my watering cans and things, and I find that the hose adapter works better for me, whether I'm filling a 5 gallon bucket or if I'm filling just a gallon recycled bucket or my actual watering can. And so once you have your barrel where you want it, and you want it on level ground, whether it's on the side yard or the patio, we just adapt another piece of spouting long enough to fit into your barrel. You wait for it to rain. And the rains are coming this weekend, so hopefully I'll get some of my barrel filled up. You will not regret it. Spend the money, go out today, get one for your side yard, get one for your patio, and get two if you have the space. I just don't. But for small backyard gardens, it's a must. Again, thanks for watching. And the rest of the week, probably see some seed planting. I have some Caladium tubers that I need to get in some soil to start getting them ready to come out in May. They need to get a boost at least 8 to 10 weeks before you want to get them out there. So we'll get those, show you how to do that. It's fun times. Again, thanks for watching Gardening on the West Fork.